on, everyone. Got a brand new movie review for you guys today, and today I'm discussing Jonah Hill's directorial debut, Mid90s. Let me start this review off with saying I was really excited to see this movie, one, because Jonah Hill's like one of my favorite actors, and knowing that he was finally going to step in as a director and also write his own movie, that got me excited. I hear he's not going to be in it. I hear it's kind of a comedy, but also a coming-of-age film. I'm all about it. Then I hear it's about skating, which is a lot of what my childhood was. And this film hit me in a lot of different spots. This film is literally my childhood, and I loved every single moment of it. You know, I decided to pull out my little skateboard right here. This is my first skateboard I bought with my own money, and it's seen some days, but I've kept it for so long because I have so many memories with it. And I absolutely love it. I wanted to share it with you guys. Again, if this is your first time catching one of my videos, thank you so much for watching. It means a ton to me. I hope you like this review. If you're new, I like talking movies. And make sure to hit that like and subscribe button if you guys enjoy this. But seriously, Jonah Hill, you have crafted an excellent movie here. One of the best things that Jonah Hill did get throughout this whole entire film was crafting such a great coming-of-age story, because the whole story follows Stevie, a 13-year-old in 90s era LA who spends his summer navigating between his troubled home life and a group of new friends that he meets at a Motor Avenue skate shop. It just felt so right. And Jonah Hill crafts this film in a very unique way, in a sense. You know, we've seen coming-of-age stories before. We've seen the troubled teens. We've seen the troubled homes. We've seen skateboarding films before. But the thing that Jonah Hill gets in here and gets it right is making you feel like you're one of the kids in this group, making you feel like you're friends with all these groups of kids. I had, like, my friends growing up, I knew one of them were at least each and every one of these guys. And it just felt so relatable in that essence. It felt like I was there, and I even looked like Stevie in a sense. I had long hair. I wore baggy jeans. I would try to skate, but I couldn't. And sometimes I got better when I got older, but it just felt relatable in that instance. And Sonny Suljic, who plays Stevie in here, is just a bright star. This kid is such a good actor, and he portrayed everything he was doing so well. You know, kid performances are hit or miss, and I think Sonny, everything I've seen him in so far, he's done great, but this is easily his best performance. Going to Lucas Hedges next, who plays Ian, his older brother, who just is a dick, you kind of understand why he is in that way, and that's kind of a pro and con for me, which I'll get into my cons in a second. But I mean, the big other standouts besides Sonny as Stevie is all the other skater kids. You have Nikhil Smith, who plays Ray, Olin Prinnett, who plays F-shit, Gio Galicia, who plays Rudin, and Ryder McClellan, who plays fourth grade. They all bring their essence to them. I have never seen them anything. From what I understand, I think this is actually their first movie they've ever been in, and it just totally works. You totally believe in these kids. You totally believe that they're skaters, and everything that they're doing, it just feels relatable down to the bone. I think one of the most strongest things about this film isn't just the directing and the way that Jonah Hill wrote this film, but within the score. Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross made the score for this, and it is excellent. There's only like four or five songs throughout it that are intertwined within the film, but when they're there, they're there, and there's something unique. One of the best scores I've heard all year long. And Jonah Hill curated the whole entire soundtrack up here from the 90s. It's what he used to listen to, and it just adds to that flavor. It really feels like Jonah Hill put his heart and passion into this film. It's a passion project of his. You feel it while you're watching this movie. As him being a first-time director, not everyone gets it perfectly on the spot. And as much as I love this film, there are a couple nitpicks I do have with it. One of the things is I think the film is a little too short. I think you could have easily added 20 minutes or more to the runtime of this to get more development with Stevie's family. I wanted a little bit more with his mom, with his brother, and I wanted a little bit more, again, with that troubled home life. I feel like there was stuff about his brother where you just feel like he's a dick, but there's one dialogue sentence where Lucas Hedges is giving this monologue and talking about how his childhood was before Stevie was born, and I feel like there's more layers to it that I think they should have gone into. And same with the mother. You wanted a little bit more of Katherine in there being this motherly role, and I understand it is mostly about Stevie. It's his coming-of-age story and him becoming this kid and who he is and trying to find his place in this world, which, again, we've seen this in coming-of-age films before, and Jonah Hill tackles it in a very different way and a very creative way at that sense. But I wanted a little bit more of the family life. I think it was something essential that we needed, and I would have liked even a little bit more with the skater gang. I think it was just so charismatic values that it brought to the screen just ooze off and again make you feel like you're one of them. Besides that nitpick, Jonah Hill did a great job directing the hell out of this film. He wrote an excellent movie. I absolutely enjoyed the hell out of Mid-90s. I think it's such a realistic feeling movie that just makes you feel like you're one of these skater kids. Maybe that is not how it is for you, but I could totally relate to this movie just with how I was growing up. I literally was Stevie. I felt like Stevie. That is exactly how it was. It's like Jonah Hill watched me growing up and wrote a film about me as a child. I love this film from beginning to end. And with all that said, I'm going to give Mid-90s an A. Please search out this one near you guys. It's getting a little bit wider release this weekend. So please tell me down below, guys, what are your guys' thoughts on Mid-90s? Were you guys excited about it? Are you not? Let's talk about it down below in the comments. If you're new here, hit that like and subscribe button. Also, go hit up Sandwichon Films down below, because right down there, you guys can actually get into advanced movie scenes. You can check out some movie news and even some movie reviews. Guys, of course, until next time, stay classy.